A horse has to be your friend, but he has to respect you. This horse may are typical as a contact issue. You'll see how symmetrical my hands are. They're very close together in basic position. I stay slightly over the corner of a horse's mouth, and I urge the horse to the frame. When the horse goes above the frame, I absolutely don't try to pull the head down. I urge the horse to the frame. And I feel, when she shakes her head, I feel a resistance. I just close my fingers a little bit, that she has to accept a short rein. She has to accept contact. The contact, Becky, must be the first criteria. The second criteria, after straight elbow to the horse's mouth, is absolutely steady hands. That the horse will have the confidence to go to the hand. The horse will take the hand. I'll start transitions, and I still, in the backward transition, I still feel the horse is in front of me. But she doesn't stop this way, fall behind me, the rider falls on the wither, and the horse falls behind me in the downward transition. You have to still feel, the first rule of riding is the forwardness in the transition. You'll see how steady she is with her head because of my very stable hands. She'll be very stable with her head, or more stable. She can't get higher than my hands, because my hands can always go higher and maintain the contact. And she can't escape backward because I have legs. So, she's going to finally realize that her comfort station is to lower her hip. And every exercise I do, I'm using my leg, however soft, and that drives her to the bit. And I get a very submissive and accepting my seat, legs, hands, purrs, whip, voice. Very happy you see this, people, because you're diehards in this weather, and this is a super example with this mare of what I talk about. This is loose. This is on, you notice the German scale. You see your rhythm, those that know the German scale. You see your rhythm. You see looseness. You see contact. You see impulsion. You see straightness. This is what they're talking about. And this is before collection. You have to have these basics before collection. Power of long range. But I still have contact with letting the horse's body stretch. And the first thing I teach the horse is he can't get above my hands. I push and bend. I push and bend. I don't bend. I push and bend. It's a very big difference. Very big difference. And she's well in front of your aids. He doesn't fall behind. The horse is always people in front of the leg and behind the hand. In front of the leg and behind the hand. In front of the leg and behind the hand. So if you go backwards, you have to remember that principle. This horse, when you stop her, hollows out and falls behind. So I have to think of the leg first. That is what I want. There's what I want. That's what I want. That's what I want. That you feel in the halt forward. You feel in the lean back forward. That the horse is forward. Like that, leg more than hand, leg more than hand. You don't have to do all of that, you know? You don't even have to understand all of it. You have to understand all of it. And you have to start to do all of it. Wonderful horse. Then she's happy because she learned. We got it. Okay, get your...